For more on all this, we turn now to Wall Street Journal reporter Dudley Althaus in Mexico City. So we've heard that there have been a number of arrests made. What's the latest?
Well, the latest is there've been a number of arrests in the past few days. They're up to about 57, according to officials. Most of them are local police from Iguala and the nearby town of Cocula, and then some local officials and members of the Guerreros Unidos gang. The latest today is the Interior Minister of Mexico has announced that they're still looking for the students alive. That was a demand from the parents of the students 2 days ago when they met with President Peña Nieto. Today in Iguala, there was a banner that appeared near the Army base and near the police headquarters saying that the students were indeed still alive and that the entire investigation has been a sham.
Human Rights Watch estimates that there have been some 20,000 disappearances over the last 8 years. Why are these particular kidnappings of these students resonating across Mexico?
Well, I think, for one, the number, the sheer numbers, and besides, you know, these kids had a reputation for kind of troublemaking, political agitation, but they're basically innocent. They're apart from the drug war, as far as anyone knows. And the sheer number of these students disappearing, plus in the past 2 years, President Peña Nieto has been saying, been assuring the country that basically the worst of the violence is behind it and that they're basically moving on. He's been really trying to promote a message of economic development, investment, and stability. This kind of just shook everybody up.
We've also heard that the mayor of the town and his wife are on the run, that they may be in on this. What does this say about how difficult it is to root out the corruption that might be inside these small towns and also working with the cartels?
Well, really, that's the most important backstory of all of this. I mean, the government, and the past government as well, but the current government as well, has been really trying to take down major drug lords, Joaquin El Chapo Guzman, the head of the Sinaloa cartel, the head of the Juarez cartel was just arrested. But what's happened was there's a lot of smaller gangs, smaller groups that still exist all throughout the bad areas of Mexico, and they've just been kind of lying low and really dominating local towns. It doesn't take much to dominate a small city or a small town in areas like Guerrero or even up on, along the border, along the U.S.-Mexico border. So that's been kind of ignored in the past 2 years, and I think this underscores that fact that these are very dangerous situations in a lot of parts of Mexico.
As you said, this has escalated into a national situation. So what's next for the federal government? What's the Mexican president likely to do?
You know, it's been 5 weeks now since these students disappeared. Something's got to give, or it starts working badly against the government. So, I mean, I think they're going to redouble their efforts. I think they're trying as far as it goes. But, I mean, you know, they have 57 people in custody. It's a relatively small area, although, you know, Guerrero's a big state. You know, most of Mexico, I think, thinks it can't be that hard to find these students. So, I mean, the government's got to come up with something very quickly, or it's losing credibility every day, I think.
All right. The Wall Street Journal's Dudley Althaus in Mexico City. Thanks so much.
Thank you.